Hello to all of you, Shabbat Shalom. We are here in Salon Agam at Art Market Gallery in Tel Aviv. Unfortunately, most of us will have to spend the weekend at home, so we thought that every weekend we try, and hopefully not too many weekends, we'll try to give you some information about our artist. And of course, we will start with the most important artist our gallery represents, Yaacov Agam. So, Yaacov Agam was born in 1928 in Rishon LeZion, and I invite the ones who were not there yet, as soon as this coronavirus situation will end, get on a plane and come to Tel Aviv, or actually to Rishon LeZion, and visit the Agam Museum that was opened about 2.5 years ago, dedicated to Agam works. So, as I said, Agam was born in 1928 in Rishon LeZion, but already in 1949 he decided to leave to Zurich in Switzerland. For 2 years he studied there under one of the most important artists in Switzerland, and then he realized, of course, that Paris is the center of art, and in 1951 he moved to Paris. Agam is the founder of the Kinetic Art movement. How did he reach to this idea of Kinetic Art? What most of us don't know is that Agam art is the art that best represents the Jewish tradition. And why so? Jewish tradition is always to be on the move, always to be changed, always to change. Since the command to bury our death on the same day and move on with our life, till the idea of startup nation, the Jewish tradition is always to move forward. And from this idea, Agam came to the idea of kinetic art, because if the Jewish tradition is moving forward all the time, and actually all reality, nothing is still, we are all the time in change, why do art? Agam asked himself, why do art has to be steady? Why when you go out, when we have a painting on the wall and we go out to work in the morning and come back in the evening, it looks the same. With Agam works of art, every second, every step we do, every angle we look at, looks different, like life itself. So how it all started? Agam moved to Paris in 1953, and actually most of his life lived in Paris, and therefore became a very well-known worldwide French artist, although all his life he presented himself as Israeli Jewish artist. Of course, he carries two citizenships, and we can share with you a nice picture that we have here from a few months ago, that French President Mr. Emmanuel Macron invited our President Mr. Ruby Rivlin to a dinner at the Elysee, and decided to invite Agam as well, as an Israeli French artist. And in the background, we can see at the Elysee Palace, in a permanent exhibit, a wall of Agam art. How it all started? We move and exhibit to the earliest work of art by Agam that we have in a gallery, is this piece, titled Never Too Late. When Agam started his career, he didn't plan that people would love to have his art on their walls at their homes, that they will like and enjoy it. He just wanted to present the idea of kinetic art. So if we look at this very, very simple work of art, which only made from 9 bars, metal bars, attached to a blackboard, one can say, why should I have this on my room, on my wall, in my house? But again, the idea of Agam is to present the idea of kinetic art. Although this work of art is very simple, it can be presented not in 10, not in 100, not in 1,000 options. There are infinite options to show you this art. Like life, life changes every second, every minute, and when I will change it, once I will change the position of the bars or the location, it will be very hard for me to get it back, to get it back to the same position, exactly like life itself. So this is the kind of art that Agam started his career. More works from this period you'll be able to see in Agam Museum. Here I can only show you what we have in one of Agam's books. So we can see here another work from that time, from 1953. As you can see again, very basic elements attached to a white board this time, but thanks to the holes in the board, you can move them to different locations, and again creates infinite possibilities of this work of art. In 1963, Agam won the first prize in Venice Biennale, and this is the work that brought him this this prize. It's hard to see, but you should imagine these are only metal coins attached with springs to a blackboard. At that time, when everybody told the audience, do not touch the art, Agam told to his people, come and touch the art. People came to the work of art, touched the coins, which moved on the springs, touched each other and created noise. So in 1963, he showed a work, a kinetic art, which also involved movement and sound. Because when the coins moved, they hit each other and created a sign. Agam was always ahead of technology, he always adopted technology, he always looked for technology to create more types of art that will show the kinetic art. So we make a jump now to the 1980s, where he first, or even late 70s, where he first introduced the Agamographs. Of course, named them after his name. We just asked the camera to move a little bit to the left or to the right, and we can do we can see the movement. This piece is created by the silk screen process, which maybe we'll discuss it on one of our other lectures. The silk screen process prints this painting with an offset on the board, and on top of it there is a special lens which includes many small prisms when the movement get the change. Nowadays, many artists in the world use this technique using digital printing, but Agam, 40, 50 years before everybody else, already introduced this technique. The most familiar media or type of work by Agam are these works that are called polymorphs. In these works, actually, one should start looking at them from what we say 0 degree, from the wall. We'll ask the camera to come close to me and start looking on this work from 0 degree. We only see black and white stripes. Now we'll ask our cameraman to go slowly all the way to the other side, step by step. And we all can see that every single step the work is changing. Every single step you see something else. Till you reach the other side of the wall, and you see a very clear circle, black circle, on a yellow background. So we started with blue and white stripes, and we ended with black on yellow circle. And that's the geniusity of Agam. That in one work of art that you have on your wall, you actually have infinite works of art. Another media which Agam created or invented is what we call the dynamograph. This work of art is titled Springtime, because you can see that the colors fits the colors of the spring. And not only you can move from one side to the other to see it changing, but you can also change it by your hand. You can move this shutter, you can move it 1 millimeter every day or every hour, whenever you want, and you have a different work of art. Agam arts did not stay in galleries or museums. Agam arts went outside. All of us, the Israelis, know the Agam fountain in Dizengoff Square, which is under renovation now. We know the Dan Hotel, and many of us know the fountain in La Défense in Paris, buildings in Miami, buildings in California, buildings in Taipei, Taiwan, and many, many other places in the world. All those works of art, although they are buildings, when you move around them, they are changing. And then, also they are building, they become the largest sculptures in the world. The kinetic art doesn't stay in galleries or museums, it goes out to the public, to the crowd. Of course, a lot of works by Agam are deliberately influenced or meaningful for the Jewish tradition. We can show one very important, especially in our days, this work, the collage, the original collage that we have here. In the center we see our Magen David and the Jacob ladder, And around we have kind of pies in different colors, which represent the different tradition, different ideas, different cultures in the Jewish tradition. But all of us gathering together around the Magen David, the David Star, and the title of this work is We All One Nation. Special pieces of art dedicated to the Jewish tradition. You can see here. Here we can see the Dreidel's menorah, Dreidel's Chanukiah, that not only we can lit Chanukah candle on top of it, but we can also play with it, with the Dreidel's. The Dreidel moves, and each candle holder can move as well. And again, not one, not ten, but infinite possibilities. Here we have the Kiddush cup, that not only it's a Kiddush cup, but it's a very nice small sculpture. Again, Kinetic. Can be also used as a Kiddush cup. It's a metal cup. Some difficulties. Okay. Metal cup, plated with white pure gold. We will now use a kippah designed by Agam to say to all of you Shabbat Shalom. Stay healthy, take care, and let us hope that this crisis will move forward, same as the kinetic art, and we will all be able to meet again in Tel Aviv or other parts of the world. Have a nice weekend, and thank you for listening.